Hello everyone and welcome back. I'm your host, Elias Sarantopoulos. In this Adobe XD tutorial, we will explore how to animate website hero images using micro interactions and time triggers to capture a user's attention. We will use the repeat grid feature to create repeating elements, link artboards, and use the auto-animate action to transition in between. All that inside Adobe XD. Inside Adobe XD, I have already brought in the Forrestal file, which is included in the exercise folder below the YouTube video description, or up in the YouTube card if you wish to follow along, since there is a lot to cover. But quickly, let's go ahead and jump into Photoshop and take a look at this file, which consists of four artboards, and each artboard represents one slide. So we have the first slide, the second slide, the third slide, and the fourth slide, okay? So back in Adobe XD, all you have to do is click on the home icon here, and then just find the file from your computer. So I'm going to marquee select those three artboards, just move them out of the way a bit here, and just focus on the first slide and talk about how we can accomplish this inside Adobe XD. For us to create a hero section with multiple slides inside Adobe XD is to use the repeat grid feature. Now the repeat grid feature changes a group of elements to a repeating element. In this case, the repeating elements include the photo, the heading, the subheading, the description text for each slide, and the pagination, which provides additional navigation options for browsing through single parts of a given slide. In this case, we're using numbers 1 out of 4, 2 out of 4, and so on. Okay. Another thing that I would like to mention, which is a very important point, that is, each slide rests in this position. So every other slide that comes in will also rest in the same position, which means we are going to measure that distance. The distance between the heading, let's say, and the far left side of the website hero section. So inside Adobe XD, all you have to do is just click on this heading here, and then hold down the Alt key or the Option key. Now you get all these numbers. In this case, we care about this number here, this 345 pixels. That's the distance between the heading and the far left side of the website hero section. So we definitely want to keep this number in mind, which will come handy very soon after. So let's talk about which elements are we going to repeat and not repeat. Well, we're definitely not going to repeat the burger menu. So I've locked this layer as well as the background color. We're also not going to repeat the left arrow or the right arrow. So go ahead and lock those layers too. But we're going to repeat the rest of the elements. So I'm going to marquee select everything. Okay, I'm going to zoom out here. And then we're going to use the repeat grid function here, which is right here in the property inspector. So if you want to use the repeat grid, all you have to do is just click on that, or you can use the shortcut, which is Control R or Command R. So go ahead and click on that. And then we're going to repeat this three more times since we already have the first slide. So I'm just going to bring this out here. And I'm going to zoom in because I want to do a good job here. So I'm going to bring this in like so. Okay. So let's see. There we go. All right. So that's the first thing. The second thing, as we talked about before, the rest of position of this slide, if you remember, we measured the distance to be 345 pixels. So we need to adjust the padding between those two elements in the repeat grid. So to adjust the space between two elements in the grid, all you have to do is hover over the gap between elements. There we go. And you see that the cursor changes to double arrows. So all we have to do inside Adobe XD is to drag to increase or decrease the padding. In this case, I'm going to drag this to the right to increase this by 345 pixels. Like so. Okay, very important point here. All right, so now we're going to ungroup the grid, and then I'm just going to focus on each of these slides. So here's the group 26. Right click and ungroup this because we need to change the information inside here. All right, so I'm just gonna double click on that, Control C or Command C, and then double click on this and paste it. We do the same for the subheading. There we go. And also for the description text, paste that as well. Let's not forget the pagination here. It will be 2 out of 4. And then lastly, we have to replace the photo. So in order to replace an image inside a grid, we're going to open the File Explorer. There we go. And these are the photos that I'm going to be using, which I'm including again in the exercise folder. So first, we're going to target which photo we want to replace. Well, in this case, we want to replace this photo, but we also have this photo BG on top of it. So first, I'm going to make this layer invisible. I'm going to hide it. So this is the photo we're going to replace. And then all I have to do is just click and drag this and bring it just right on top on the other photo to replace it. And then in the photo BG layer, I'm just going to make this visible again. There we go. And let's see, I'm just marquee select everything. And then right click and group this. Okay. So go ahead and repeat the same process and replace the remaining elements for the rest of the website hero section for the remaining multiple slides. And so inside Adobe XD, let's go ahead and create a first micro interaction, which is transitioning from one slide to another using the auto-animate action. So first I'm going to marquee select these artboards. I'm just going to delete them because I'm not going to use them. And then I'm going to marquee select the first artboard, the first slide, and group those elements. So Control G or Command G. And now I'm left with a group and all these locked items, the layers, the left arrow, the right arrow, the burger menu, and the BG. This is exactly what I wanted to have. So the micro interaction will take place between two artboards. So we need to create another duplicate of this. So click on that and then hold down the Alt key to create another duplicate and just bring this down. Double click here and rename this to, let's say, final, like so. So inside Adobe XD, when we wire two artboards using the auto animate, XD will animate the difference in properties between each artboard. This could be an opacity, the color, the text, size, and position of an object. Now you have to keep in mind that all the name of the layers have to be exactly the same. So in this case, we will auto-animate the difference in the position property. So what I mean by that is, I'm going to just double click here and marquee select those and just hold down the Shift key and just bring those to the left a bit, like so. And we're going to animate the position between this artboard to this artboard, okay? So for that, we need to jump into the prototype mode. And then we're going to click on the object we want to link. In this case, this is this artboard will link to the next artboard. Now, when we do that, this arrow appears right next to the object. When you hover over your mouse over the handle, a cursor changes to a connector. Click and start dragging your mouse to see the connector. There we go. And then just wire this up to the next artboard. Okay, this is going to be a time-based trigger. It's not going to be a tap. It's going to be time-based. No need for delays. The action will be the, instead of transition, the auto-animate. Destination, the first slide, final. Ease-in will be ease-in for me. And then duration, 1 second is fine as well. So let's go ahead and make sure that you click on this slide. I'm going to click on the desktop preview. And let's go ahead and run this preview here. There we go. Exactly what I want is I wanted to have difference in properties, in the positional properties between each slide, each artboard. In this case, using the auto animate, like so. So now let's go ahead and work on creating more micro interactions inside Adobe XD. So for that, I'm just going to select this artboard and just bring it right next to the other one, like so. And then I'm going to create another duplicate. So I'm going to hold down the Alt key to create another duplicate. Double click to rename this to second slide. And the second slide will come in. So click on that and then click and drag. Hold down the shift key as you do to bring in the second slide. Again, I'm going to zoom in here. I'm going to use the left arrow key. I'm going to tap on that and make sure I place it exactly at the edge, like so. Okay. All right. Now we're going to create another duplicate of the second slide. So hold down the Alt key. There you go. Double click, rename this to final. And again, we're going to have a position property animating. So double click on that. And hold down the Shift key as you move this to the left, like so. Okay. Okay, so the micro interaction between those two artboards using the auto-animate will be just on the position property. So I'm just going to wire this up right here. Again, the trigger will be time-based, action auto-animate, and the rest stays the same. Now, how about if the user wants to actually click on the preview slide and wants to go to the preview slide, the first slide? So for that, we're going to target the left arrow and we're going to wire this up to the first slide, but this time the trigger will be tap, okay? So tap on click, the action will be auto animate and the rest stays the same. We do exactly the same thing on the end of the first slide. The user can click on this arrow here, the right arrow, and they can go to the next slide. Again, the trigger will be tap, the action auto animate, and the rest stays the same. So let's go ahead and test that with the desktop preview. Let's go ahead and run this. Here we go. This is the first slide. It animates the position property animates. We go to the second slide. Again, the position animates, the position property animates, and we can see here the pagination numbers. Let's go back to the first slide. There we go, and everything works exactly the way it's supposed to work. So now all you have to do is repeat the same process, connecting artboards and slides together for the rest of the micro interactions to take place. One last thing that I would like to mention here is that when the user taps or clicks to go to the next slide, as you can see, the navigation or the burger menu is hidden. So all we have to do is target this layer here, this burger menu, and just bring this up on the layer stack, like so. And we do this for each of these artboards. And once you finish that, then the slideshow will run perfect the way it's supposed to run. So let's do a quick preview here. Let's run this. Let's go to the next slide. And there you go. The burger menu or the navigation is not hidden. Thank you everyone for spending time with me. Let me know if you have any questions and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to get the latest tutorial updates.